thank the press preseason for telling the story that you guys tell. We'll try to make our players available within reason, but we do appreciate the coverage we get. And I notice there's a, or I see there's a great group of boosters here today also. And I want to thank you guys for what you do for South Dakota State, making a difference, and both in the stands and with your pocketbooks. So thank you. So we have a lot to be optimistic about. Obviously, the new stadium, which is our home now. We've been practicing there the whole fall camp. We had the best summer by Coach Moe's measurement in terms of numbers and gains. The expectations continue to rise, surely outside the locker room, but more importantly, inside the locker room. And what I'm really excited about is our senior class. We have a great group of captains and a great group of seniors that have done a tremendous job of leading this football team. They had dinner at our house last night, and I remind them, the team will go where they go. They have a greater influence than any of our coaches, so I'm looking forward to where they take the team. Last season, I talked about a new recipe. We lost the Zenners and Sumners and Schneiders of South Dakota State football, and our guys responded to that for our fourth playoff experience or participation. But that wasn't good enough. And so, again, our guys in the locker room are setting their sights higher. Last year, I also said we had a huge positive in terms of our staff being intact, and that came back to bite me because I had to hire four new coaches in the spring. But that is reason to be optimistic also. We hired four really, really good coaches, and I'd like to name off all those guys. Offensive line, Jason Eck. Safeties and co-special teams coordinator, Jake Dickert. Wide receivers, Robert Arnheim. Running backs, John Johnson. And then the veterans are offensive coordinator and quarterback coach, Eric Eidsness. Defensive coordinator and defensive ends coach, Clint Brown. Defensive tackles coach, Jesse Currier. Linebackers coach, Jimmy Rogers. Cornerback coach, Dan Jackson. Tight end and co-special teams coordinator Luke Schleichner. And then our strength coach, does a tremendous job with our program, Nate Moe here in the blue shirt. So he didn't want to mess up his white shirt for press day. So give him. I've told these guys, and I'm serious about this, I've told these coaches that there's no doubt in my mind this is the best staff I'm going to be have an opportunity to be around at South Dakota State, so the pressure's on those guys. Where this football team goes, yes, is on the shoulders of the seniors, but it also starts, I've said it for 20 years now, with the fat guys, the lines, and we are blessed to have the leader of our defensive line, Cole Langer, coming back for a fourth year of starting. He's a special player. Offensively, we're led on the line by Jake Onosorgi, who's a three-year starter at center. We do have some gifted players, some guys that we would call difference makers. Jake Winicky, a wide receiver, Dallas Godert at tight end, Jesse Bobbitt at linebacker, Nick Mears at safety, along with a bunch of other guys that will contribute. Last year we lettered 59 guys, so obviously a lot of guys get involved. And then finally, 20 years ago when I became the head football coach, I called a number of guys I considered wise head football coaches, and one of them told me that the best thing you can have coming back is a starting quarterback. Well, we have two starting quarterbacks coming back, so I'm not going to answer any questions on that scenario, okay? We're looking forward to the trip to TCU and more looking forward toward being part of history out here and opening up the new stadium. So looking forward to talking to all of you. Thanks.